What's up guys, Sal here. So earlier this year, Samsung decided to use high refresh rate displays on their flagships. The Galaxy S20 series is the first Samsung phone to have a 120Hz display. The newly announced Galaxy Note 20 Ultra as well as the Galaxy Tab S7 Plus also have a 120Hz display. A higher refresh rate display actually makes a big difference to the end user, and people appreciated Samsung for these high refresh rate panels. But what they didn't appreciate though is the fact that they cannot use these high refresh rate displays at maximum resolution. It wasn't possible on the S20 Ultra, and it isn't possible on the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra. But strangely enough, it is possible on the Galaxy Tab S7 Plus. That's right, the Tab S7 Plus runs 120Hz at Quad HD resolution. The reason it wasn't enabled on the S20 Ultra is that the processor does not provide the required bandwidth to drive the higher refresh rate at Quad HD Plus resolution. It looks like that was partially true, because it's clear from the Galaxy Tab S7 Plus that the Snapdragon 865 Plus supports the required bandwidth for 120Hz at Quad HD resolution. For those of you who don't know, Samsung decided to use only the Snapdragon 865 Plus for the Tab S7 worldwide. There's no Exynos variant, which means it's the Exynos 990 that isn't capable of providing the high refresh rate bandwidth for maximum resolution. The Snapdragon chipset, on the other hand, can absolutely do that. Since the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra uses two chipsets, they cannot enable the 120Hz at max on one chipset and leave out on the other without inviting backlash from Exynos users. Exynos users are already mad that they are getting an inferior performing chipset compared to Snapdragon, so if Samsung decided to enable 120 at max on Snapdragon and not on Exynos would only make things even worse. This probably also explains why OnePlus can do 120Hz at Quad HD Plus and Samsung, the creator of these display panels, cannot. And it's all because of Exynos. Let's hope with all the rumored makeover Exynos is getting next year that they can at least be able to catch up to Qualcomm and Snapdragon. Surprisingly, at the Unpacked event, Samsung didn't actually talk much about the Galaxy Z Fold 2. They semi-revealed it and promised to reveal every remaining detail about the handset on September 1st. We of course have the official hands-on, but nothing beats an honest hands-on video that isn't from Samsung. Thankfully, we have just that today. The Z Fold 2 has been spotted in the wild, showcasing it from many angles. It shows what the official video didn't. Crease is similar to the original Fold. It's the only big drawback of foldable right now, but just like the Note, you'll get used to it and it stops bothering after some time. Again, kudos to Samsung for bringing so much improvement to this year's Fold over its first generation. They've got everything right as far as the hardware and software are concerned. All they need to do now is price it similar to the original Fold or maybe even cheaper. If they want people to consider buying the foldables, then they need to bring that cost down. And I'm hopeful that it happens at some point. Of course, with that being said, do consider subscribing for all the latest updates on smartphone tech. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.